So should you remove the EGR valve on your car? What is the EGR? What's it do? How's it work? Is it robbing you of performance? We're going to look at the EGR valve. It crops up a lot on forums, on our site. We get a lot of questions about it. A lot of people are asking, should they delete the EGR valve? And whether there's pros and cons of removing this valve from your engine or not. I would really love to hear your experiences of EGR deletes. Why did you have your EGR deleted? Did you notice a performance gain after it was removed? And perhaps you've just had an EGR valve cleaned or replaced. Did you notice a performance benefit after you had that work done on your car? So the EGR valve is the exhaust gas recirculation valve. So in theory, it allows the engine to reduce its harmful emissions. So the nitrous oxides that would be emitted from the engine are somewhat reduced when some of the warm exhaust gases goes into the intake, and that warmer charge of air going in alters the efficiency of the engine. So is that something that's going to damage your performance? Well, most EGR systems only operate at light throttle and when the engine is warming up. So at wide open throttle under load, when you want the maximum performance from your engine, your EGR valve is naturally closed. So as a device on your car, it's not robbing you of performance. It's there at the low RPMs, reducing the emissions. So the problem that a lot of people have with the EGR valve though, is that they clog up, they fill up with soot. And with any engine that's burning fuel, particularly diesel fuel, you are going to get soot building up. It'll typically build up around the head of the engine. The EGR valve itself, it's not surprising it clogs up in there because it's quite a complex pipe system. There's a valve there that opens and closes and regulates the flow of exhaust gases into the intake. And modern systems are actually quite well designed. So should you actually delete it? Well, in most areas, regions and states, if you want your car to be legal, you shouldn't delete it because an EGR delete will generally render your car illegal. The emissions will not be within the standards that the authorities expect. So if they did an inspection on your car and found it deleted, you could find yourself with some sort of citation or fine or getting your car confiscated. So usually most people have come along and they've got a problem with the car. It's usually a check engine light that's come on. And it's often down to the fact that the EGR valve has started to become clogged. It can no longer flow the air around. So it's effectively closed itself up and it's not operating, but the engine is detecting that and flagging it up as a problem on the dashboard. And in some cases, it may even be backing off on the performance. And you may also find that that carbon and soot buildup within the head and through the EGR valve itself is also robbing you of performance. Getting your EGR valve cleaned will certainly restore that lost performance and prevent you from having those side effects and those problems. But a lot of people are going out and investigating EGR delete kits. So these can vary in price wildly from just a basic blanking plate that blanks off the EGR valve and the inlet on the intake manifold. Some have a cooler system as well connected to them, so you would just need to work all of that in. And other kits are much more complex. They change the design of the exhaust itself, so there's not really anything leading up to branch off and go through an EGR system at all. So depending on your car and the setup, I've heard a lot of problems that people have had with just blanking plates on some engines because you've effectively got a Y pipe and the blanking plate just goes onto part of the Y pipe and you've got weird pressure building up within that part of the Y up to the blanking plate. And that can have adverse effects on the longevity of the engine and also just the way the exhaust gases are flowing out of the engine themselves. So do your research carefully. Make sure you get a good quality EGR kit that's designed for your engine. If you do have an engine that you can just blank off successfully, then by all means go for it. But there's nearly always a requirement to make an adjustment in the ECU. So if the engine computer detects that the EGR valve is not working properly, i.e. it's been blanked off, it's going to flag up some kind of error. It may even back off on the performance. So EGR deletes are both a physical modification that has to be done to an engine, but they also require a software adjustment to be done. I'd really just like to put the information out there that EGR valves are not necessarily bad devices in themselves. It's another area within the engine that may clog up with soot and cause you problems. But there are so many issues that can crop up with an engine. It's impossible to remove them all, and you've got to ask yourself, why have manufacturers designed a system has got this exhaust gas recirculation system? They've obviously spent a lot of time and effort, and they don't really want it to be robbing the engine of its performance or its efficiency, although they are making compromises in the name of fuel economy and emissions standards. So an EGR delete can also help to reduce the carbon buildup. A lot of direct injection diesel engines are plagued with carbon buildup on the intake valves, but don't think that removing your EGR valve is going to prevent that problem. The main contributor to carbon buildup on the intake is generally the crankcase ventilation, where droplets of oil are mixing with the air and that bakes on to the intake valves. So you'll minimize the problem a little bit by locking off the EGR valve and not having those exhaust gases going back into the engine through the valves. But don't expect that to completely eliminate the problem. It doesn't usually fix that issue on most cars that have that issue. So I hope this video has been interesting to you. Please let me know your experiences. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. We would love you to stay tuned, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.